You hungry? You want me to cook some breakfast? Hey, I got something for you. Wait right here. Don't move. I might become a hitman target. I had a rule about that sort of thing. If the killer didn't get me, I'd go after his boss, even if it was my own. Murder in Cosa Nostra was for control, discipline, and to maintain power. The code that would trigger a hit was very simple. You break the rules, you get whacked. When I went after another killer, when I knew it would be his life or mine, I told myself, you have the advantage, you have the offense, but a single mistake with the guy who killed the Garofalo nephews, and it would be bye-bye Joseph. Now charged with excitement and determination, I could not consider turning back. Not even heroin supplied a rush as powerful as the moments before a kill. At times, things seemed to go into slow motion. Sometimes I could almost feel the bullet leaving the gun. Never even heard the gunshot. My mind so focused on my victim, the enemy. Sometimes the guy's dead looked so peaceful, so surreal, as if they were sleeping. And at that moment, I realized I had the power of life and death. And when I took another life, I was a predator, an animal hunting my prey.
Thank you. What was it like for you in prison, Joseph?
You just wait for the time. Well, you just wait for the time to pass. Don't let it get the best of you. But I thought about you a lot. And that helped me to get through it.
So what now?
Well, I'm here. I am out. Anything can happen.
Everything is working out.
Go beat.
I want him dead.
When?
Yesterday I want him dead. Well, you do what you gotta do.
Guy walks into the sperm bank, right? He's got a ski mask on, he got a pistol in his hand, he goes up to the receptionist, he says, all right, open up the vault. She says, wait a minute, this is not a bank, don't have money, open up the fucking vault. She opens the vault up, he says, now take out one of them vials. Takes out a vial, he says, now drink it. She drinks the vial, takes off the mask, it's the lady's husband. He said, no, that wasn't so hard, was it?
Oh, that's a good one.
Oh, no, John, drink's on me. Yeah, she.
In any case, I'll have a few more over here.
Hey.
Yeah, here's to you, John.
Salud, I too, eh? Yeah.
To me, salud. Salud.
Yeah.
I'm hungry. You guys hungry?
You hungry? Let's go eat. Let's go down to Deli.
Oh, fuck the Deli. They got shit food. What do you want to eat?
Oh, there's a good place on 56. They have a good Italian salami.
Sandwiches. No, I got your salami over here. Fuck that shit. Come on. Frankie's for sausage and peppers. Oh, I'm thinking about that.
All right. Frankie's. Your call. What do you want?
That's what I want.
I didn't want anything to do with hitting
you. You all right with that?
And thought maybe he
was. Come on, you know, you've been a piece of shit all night. Let's
that
go.
There was another reason. They wanted him killed.
Well, let's go.
And they didn't want me to know about it. I made a lot of money working for him. And he was a good friend who always helped me out. But business was business. I didn't feel good about this at all.
He told me to come to you because you are trusted.
Trusted. What trusted? Everybody trusts me. But I am the guy who gets his ass kicked. I am the guy who goes down because of so many fucking assholes doing the fucking job instead of other people doing the job. I am the guy who
goes fuck it then. If I have to do the fucking job myself, I'll do it. But he told me to ask you. I have to get it cleared from him. If you don't like it, fuck
this is a fucking job. The fucking job. Always a fucking job. And I always have to do it. Why don't you do it? Why don't she just do it?
He asked me to ask you to do it. If you want me to do it, I'll go ask him. I say, I'll
get
permission.
Then you do the job.
I don't have
me.
He told me to tell you. I don't have his permission to do the job. He told me to tell you specifically. That's why I'm here. You think I want to be fucking here talking to you? I'm losing money talking to you right now.